Championship Monday, folks. I'm Colin Ritzik. Welcome to a throwback of a tournament, the Peach State Classic, historic Peach State Classic, should I say. This tournament used to be one of the biggest in Georgia, one of the biggest in the United States. It's been on hiatus, and it's back now. Last was in 2007 at Morehouse. We're here at Alexander in Douglasville, Georgia, for the girls' championship game between the Tucker Tigers and the Westlake Lions. Tucker 7-3 coming into this matchup. Westlake 7-1. Both teams were 2-0 in the region. It's up and Tucker's got it. Early three-pointer. And Westlake's got their first possession of the game. Out of bounds, Tucker ball. Good hustle on defense from the Tigers. That was Jayla Morrow and Bria Bass on the defense there, trapping the corner. Spin move, no good. Out of bounds, Tucker's going to stay with it. Starting for the Tigers, number one, Jayla Morrow. Number 13, Najla Samsedine. Number 15, Bria Bass. Number 21, Kiera Johnson Graham. And number 45, Maria Tremble. Another three ball, no good for the Tigers. And here's the Westlake Lions' first meaningful possession. Their three is no good. So far, three threes, none of which have landed. Bria Bass, good look inside. Kiera Johnson Graham with the layup. Good pass through the lane to Graham down low. That shot rattles around and goes in for the Lions. That's number 20, Marissa Cantrell, their point guard. Westlake's a good shooting team. They're going to score a lot of points. Saw their first game of the year at St. Francis, and you got to think first game's kind of rusty, and they were shooting good from then. So I can only imagine they've gotten better. Three from Jayla Morrow, that's no good. Rebounded, Rakea Williams. Loose ball, Tucker gets it back. Little high. Westlake's playing man defense. That pass was just over the mark for number 21, Kiera Johnson Graham down low. Anastasia Warren with the ball. Hazendove to Cantrell. Cantrell, Hazendove, and Warren are a potent guard trio. Good passers, good dribblers, and good shooters. They're going to live from the shot outside and die by the shot outside. Good pass inside. Taylor Hazendove. Opportunistic. Drive, spin, off balance, foul. Bria Bass goes to the floor. She'll head to the line to shoot two. That foul is on Rakea Williams. First one, no good. Early sub already. Kiera Guthrie. Bass's second is good. Tucker in transition, they've got numbers. Pass it outside, they're gonna reset. Another good open man down low. Great pass from Jayla Morrow down to Maria Trimble, the senior. Wide open down low, that's two times from the same spot on the floor. Tucker's gotten 2 points off a cross court pass. off-balance shot from Rekaya Williams, but she's going to go to the line. They've got a good mix, do the Westlake Lions. Rekaya Williams, center, 6'1", junior, can move bodies down low. She can score points in the paint. But like I said, those shooters are what Westlake likes to live and die by. Second free throw is good. First one was no good. That's Williams' first point on the night. 5-5 here early in the first. Kiara Guthrie backs it out to Morrow. Back to Guthrie on the wing. Not a lot of movement early here on Tucker. Hazendove rebounds. Warren gets it stolen. Hazendove picks it back up off the floor. Cantrell out wide, three-pointer, short. That's stuck. That three was Kennedy Hansberry. Ball is going to go to Tucker. Let's see if the refs have any ups. Oh, so close. Who wants it? Who wants it? Give the man a ball. He doesn't want to get embarrassed twice. Oh, but he does. You got it. Didn't even make contact on that one. Fourth time is a charm. All right. Learning experience here early for the Zebras. Anastasia Warren to inbound. She's got Cantrell, Rekaya Williams, Taylor Hazendove, and Kennedy Hansberry on the floor. Into Hansberry. Loose ball. Out of control. On the line is Tucker. Back to Westlake it goes. Cantrell not afraid to pull it as we've seen so far. They give it back to her. Pulls it again. In and out. Couldn't have gotten much closer. Like the hustle I've seen so far from both of these teams, that's the third time we've had girls on the floor chasing after loose balls. Jaylen Morrow is going to go to the line to shoot two. This is our first of two championship games here tonight at Alexander. Up later we'll have the Whitfield Wolf Pack versus the Farrell Panthers out of Atlanta. Bass's first is good. Pardon me, Morrow. Jaylen Morrow's first is good. As is her second. Passed up ahead to Cantrell. Westlake likes to push the floor. Guards are quick and they can dribble, so anytime they can get in transition, they will do it. And Cantrell has just been jacking up shots from the right baseline all night. Great pass, great pass. Jaylen Morrow into Guthrie. Bounce pass, fundamentals. Cantrell at top of the key, dishes over to Warren. Inside to Hansberry, pardon me, Hazendove. Her shot's no good. Again, Tucker Tigers on the floor. They benefit from it. Foul called on Kennedy Hansberry, number 10. Tucker's 7-3 coming into this game with wins over Fayette County, Stevenson, Bolingbrook, Illinois, Wesleyan, Paideia, Rockdale County, Newton, and Langston Hughes. That win over Langston Hughes coming last night, 77-36 was that score. Anastasia Warren to Kennedy Hansberry to Cantrell. Back to Warren, back to Cantrell. Paris Mullins has entered the game. She's took over Raquel Williams for the post duties. Another shot from Cantrell. That one more off than any of them so far. She puts it back up. Finally gets a roll. Marissa Cantrell. Not for lack of trying. Rim is finally kind to her, and she gets her second shot of the night. 4 points for Cantrell. Bria Bass up top for the Tigers. Bass, Kiara Guthrie, three ball. That's money. That's our first three of the night. And the Tigers out to a 12-7 lead early. Good movement. Hasendove open down low, but she cannot finish. Bria Bass takes on Cantrell. Just missed the mark. Warren pushing the floor. Mullins down low. Warren goes up, gets fouled. She'll go to the line. First free throw is good. Second free throw just as good. That's Anastasia Warren's fourth. Najla Samson-Dean brings it up. So far, Tucker's done a good job of working the ball along the perimeter and getting the opportunistic pass down low when it's available, but they're not forcing anything, which is good so far. Good pass. Back out. They're going to call it for a travel. Yep. Gwendolyn Hughes on the travel. Hansberry cross court to Warren. She doesn't like it. Cantrell up top. Stolen. Good hands from Najla Samson-Deed on the steal. She gets the ball. Good pass down low. Way to handle it. But the shot is just off from Kiara Johnson-Graham. The pass was a good idea, just a touch high for Johnson-Graham. Cantrell up top. She gets her stuff blocked, but rebounds it, puts it up off the back of the backboard and out of bounds. So Marissa Cantrell struggling early for the Westlake Lions. She is, if not their go-to, one of their top two go-to players. She's always looking to find the basket. That's an air ball. Rebounded, though. Taylor Hasendove puts it up. Good finish. Kiara Johnson-Graham finishes what she started last possession on an excellent pass there from Kiara Guthrie down low. Johnson-Graham did a great job of crowding that ball in and staying composed, putting the shot back up. Three ball up and off. No good. That's going to be it for the first quarter. A quick first quarter. No timeouts, hardly any fouls. 14-11. The Tucker Tigers lead the Westlake Lions. Don't go anywhere, folks. Got a lot of action coming right around the corner. 2015 Peach State Classic. Championship games here on a Monday. 14-11, the Tucker Tigers lead the Westlake Lions after one. Grip. Base drives down low, gets her pass intercepted, but picked up from Johnson Graham. She puts it in. Pardon me, Quinlan Hughes. 16-11, Tucker leads. This Tigers team has taken advantage of their opportunities when they have them. A couple loose balls below the basket have been corralled in and put up for points. Tucker's patient on offense. They work the ball around the perimeter. They put it inside when they can, but they don't force shots. Whereas tonight, Westlake has been doing almost nothing but forcing shots. Good work inside. Bounce pass to base outside. That's no good. Cantrell with the rebound. Her drive, no good. And the transition bucket is easy for Najla Sam-Sadid. And that's going to be a timeout from Westlake. So 18-11 here early. Got a good crowd for a few days before Christmas. We just watched Morrow come back from about 8 points down. With a little over 2 minutes in the consolation games on the boys' division. Morrow claims third place. Champion will be crowned after this game. On the floor for Westlake, Taylor Hosendove, Marissa Cantrell, Anastasia Warren, Kennedy Hansberry, and Rakea Williams. They're starting five. I'd like to see some more ball movement from the Lions. Try to get Williams involved down low. They do have a size advantage right now. They tried it. Pass is just a little off, so they're going to go back up top and reset it. Warren into Rakea Williams. Good move, but nothing doing. She passes out. Reset again. They're going to call her for a travel. Taylor Hosendove tries to make a move on the baseline. They're going to say she shuffled her feet. I didn't see it, but they don't care what I think. On the floor for Tucker, Najla Sam-Sadid, Bria Bass, Maria Trimble, Jayla Morrow, and Chakiera Cook. Warren, one-on-one. Pull-up floater's no good. Rebounded, but taken right out of her hands by Maria Trimble. Why go for the rebound when you can just steal it from the person who does rebound it? Jayla Morrow up top. She passes to Bass, back to Morrow. Inside, two-on-one for Westlake. Warren Hansberry, but they couldn't get anything going. Good drive. Taylor Hosendove recognized a slit in the defense and exploited it. And then she gets a rebound and is going to push it again. Up to Warren. Warren falling to the floor, can't convert the jumper out to Rakea Williams. She gets fouled. Najla Sam-Sadid. Adasia Crumby coming in for Anastasia Warren. This is Crumby's first action of the night. She passes out to Cantrell. Over for an open three from Hansberry. That's good. Kennedy Hansberry Her first points of the night. Bria Bass in the baseline. Good fake hesitation, but just underneath the rim, couldn't get it going. She got hit in the head and is holding something in her hand. Might be a contact, might be something else, but. Number 21, Kiara Johnson-Graham will come in to relieve her. Cantrell of Westlake brings it up the floor. Hansberry to Hosendove, to Williams from the free throw line. She gets knocked down as she shoots. She'll head to the line. Kiara Johnson-Graham just got too much of her on a body check and will send Rakea Williams to shoot two. Williams is 1-for-2 from the line already today. Missed her second as well. Johnson Graham pushes it up the floor to Shamsin Deed, who gets fouled. Najla Shamsin Deed is 5'2 and a senior, but she is not afraid to tack it down low. It's the second time tonight we've seen her charge head first into the paint. This time she's rewarded from the line. First one's good. Paris Mullen checks in for the Westlake Lions. Shamsin Deed's second is good. Hansberry up top to Warren. Cantrell on the baseline. Good pump fake. She gets blocked as she tries to make a move to the basket. That one's on Chakiera Cook. That's her second foul in about 2 minutes. You got to think she'll come out of the game, and yes, she does here for Quinlan Hughes. Hughes, the 5'11 senior. Inbounds play designed for Cantrell was snuffed out by the Tigers. Hansberry, three ball. Air ball. Tigers in transition. Jayla Morrow, pass inside, broken up by Hansberry, out to Warren. They've got a 3-on-1. Cantrell takes it. Good finish from Cantrell with the right hand on the left side. Blows right by Kiara Johnson-Graham. And Westlake, despite their shooting woes, is within 2 points here. The Tigers started hot and have cooled off a little bit since then. 20-18 is our score. A little under 4 minutes until halftime. Hansberry, Cantrell, three up top. Pass it out to Warren. Three from the wing. Too far. Mullins rebound. Left hand's good. Paris Mullins with her first points of the night. Good rebound and put up from the freshman, Paris Mullins. And then she adds some defense on the other side. Swats the ball away, but Anastasia Warren commits the holding foul. That is Westlake's fifth foul. Fifth foul for Westlake, sixth foul for Tucker. The three's no good from Shamsin Deed. Up top to Hansberry. In transition, her 2 points are good. Kennedy Hansberry, wide open, easy buckets. Morgan Collins. Chance indeed. Good pass in to Johnson Graham, but she gets fouled on the way up. Good inbounds play. Graham was open. She gets bumped by Maya Johnson of Westlake. So let's see if Johnson Graham can do anything from the free throw line. First one's no good. Westlake leads 22-20. Johnson Graham's second, nothing but net. 22-21. Hansberry up the floor to Cantrell. Hansberry's trapped in the corner into Mullins. They're going to call her for a travel. Mullins never really had a good feel for the ball. Tried to put it on the floor. Walked in the process, and Tucker ball it is. Errant pass there for Morgan Collins. She was looking for Shams indeed. And Cantrell leads the charge for the Lions. Contested three, no good. Deja White with the rebound. She dips it out to Hansberry. Hansberry will try a deep two. That one is good. Back of the rim. Kennedy Hansberry shooting good tonight for the Lions. Maria Trimble out. Johnson Graham, three. Good. Johnson Graham, the lefty from the baseline, three. And that's going to tie it up at 24 apiece. Who can make a charge here before halftime? Deja White. Into Hasendove. She, ooh, travel, they say. Looked like she got hand-checked. That's the second time tonight Hasendove's gone to make a move and shuffled her feet in the process. Morgan Collins drives, splits the defenders high off the glass, no good. Rebounded Hasendove. Hansberry, Maya Johnson, nothing. Cantrell from the elbow. That's short. Johnson rebounds out to Hasendove. 18-footer off the rim, off the backboard. Rebounded Johnson Graham. Knocked out of bound by Cantrell. Tucker keeps the ball. Minute and 10 seconds left. Najla Shamsundeen. Pass is broken up by Hansberry. That pass is broken up by Trimble. Trimble drives the paint, three on one. Up and under's no good, but a good move. She just could not finish. Deja White, dribble drive, behind the back, dishes out wide. Hasendove gets her shot blocked. Rebounded, Shamsundeen. She's going to take on the defender again. Good move again, but can't finish. So Shamsundeen can dribble. She can drive, get by defenders. Hasn't had a whole lot of luck finishing yet tonight. And Cantrell holds up one. They're going to look for one shot unless you get a wide open layup like that one. But Maya Johnson was a little too hard off the glass. But she gets the loose ball. Hasendove. Fade away post jumper's good. Johnson Graham knocks the ball out. Westlake's going to have one more opportunity here with 4 seconds left before halftime. Deja White inbounds to Cantrell. She's got Hasendove, Hansberry, and Maya Johnson on the floor. Two, Cantrell, three ball. That's good. Into the locker room they go. Marissa Cantrell sent them off the best way you could with a three. The best team score right before the half. And that's what Westlake does. They lead Tucker 29-24. We're going to head to halftime. Y'all don't go anywhere. I'm Colin Ritzik with Lisa Burnett running the show with me. We're here at the Peach State class at Alexander High School. Don't go anywhere, folks.
The feeling of the perfect shot feels effortless to me. Right when I release that shot, it just feels serene and quiet. It's only me and the rim and the basketball. With my height, to have an impact and to be the player that I wanted to be, I needed to change my shot, and that was going to be something that would be beneficial for the long term. The process started just breaking my shot down from the initial release to the follow-through. And there were days that I couldn't even get the ball to the rim. There were days that I couldn't go outside of the paint area. It was very frustrating to not be able to shoot the way that I wanted to. The hardest part of that process was definitely the patience. But if I just stuck to getting better every day, eventually I would be able to shoot where I wanted to anywhere on the floor. I went through some tough days, but found a way to just persevere and see it through. It starts with a great base and great foundation and allows everything to feel perfect. I can do all things.
Welcome back, folks. Second half action right ahead. Westlake 29, Tucker 24. A resilient first half from Westlake. Started off slow, poor shooting, not real great passing, and left some holes open on the defense. But that second quarter hit their shots, played real good defense, and were very opportunistic underneath the glass. At one point down 18-11. They now lead 29-24. Cantrell starts where she let off, shooting the ball. Just missed, though. Rebound, Maria Trimble. She pushes the floor. She's got an open man on the baseline. That's Jayla Morrow. That jump shot just off the front of the rim. No good. But it stays with Tucker. Shamson Dean. In pass to Johnson Graham. That's no good. Cantrell skies for the rebound. She pushes the floor, takes on four defenders, gets it blocked, and falls out of bounds. Westlake keeps it. Anastasia Warren in the rebound. She's got Hansberry open on the three. Doesn't seem to want to pass it to her. Instead, tries to force it to Cantrell, gets it stolen for Morrow. Morrow on Cantrell, dribble drive, picks up the dribble. Good pass to Johnson Graham. She can't put up a good shot. Out to Shamson Dean, her shot's no good. And Johnson Graham, who couldn't finish earlier, will get another shot as she gets sent to the line to shoot two. The lefty's first shot is good. Her second also is good. Makes it a three-point game. Cantrell on the wing. She's going to send it to Hansberry to restart. Hazendova Mullins come up top to set ball screens. Dishes to Hazendova, off ball screen from Cantrell. She comes back out to get the ball. Gets it stripped from Shamsin Dean, but out of bounds it goes. Hansberry to Warren up top. She's calling for a screen. Hansberry, Warren inside to Hazendove. Good pass back out to Hansberry. She picks up the dribble. Hazendove down low. Into Warren for two. Good cut from Anastasia Warren. And good recognition from Hazendove to get her the bounce pass. But Jayla Morrow answers with a three of her own. Back to 2 points. Warren, baseline jumper, that's good. 33-29. Morrow on Cantrell. She puts the body into her, they're going to give her two shots. She goes down hard. Jayla Morrow in obvious pain. Coach Robin Potter out there to check it out, holding her hand. Hopefully it's just a stinger, maybe a bad finger jam or something. Hopefully nothing's broken or sprained too bad. And we'll see Jayla Morrow return. But for now, Kiara Guthrie checks in for the point guard. And because it was an injury that she left with, Kiara Guthrie will be allowed to shoot the 2 points. They're not going to force Morrow to shoot two with an injured hand. Her first no good. Guthrie's sophomore guard. Second free throw is good to make it a three-point game. Warren to Cantrell. Back to Warren to Hansberry. Long two. They're going to call it a three. Hansberry's been on tonight. They need to keep feeding her. Good spin move from Johnson Graham. She has had no luck finishing tonight. I'd like to see that continue to happen there for Tucker. Tucker had good ball movement earlier in the game. Working around the perimeter, getting it down to the low post. They got away from that in the second quarter. I'd like to see more of that here in the third quarter from Tucker. These are going to start falling at some point for Kiara Johnson Graham, the senior, the 6 foot senior. She's working hard. Guthrie up top, over to Shamsin Dean. Base with a three. That one's just short. Rebound, Maria Trimble. Base drives the lane, gets it stripped, gets it back, puts it up, no good, gets it back again, puts it up, gets it back again, dishes out to Trimble, and she gets fouled and goes to the line. Three rebounds on one play for Bria Bass. She would have liked to add 2 points to that, but just could not get it to go. Good defense down low from the freshman, Paris Mullins. She was helped out by Taylor Hazendove as well. But Maria Trimble to the line. Her first is good. Tucker is 2-0 in Region 2, 6A. They're tied with Lovejoy for the first place spot in that region. Both teams are 2-0. Tucker's trying to take a de facto lead here tonight. Cantrell's shot no good, but the ball stays with Westlake. Inbound to Hansberry. She's guarded well by Sham Sandin. Cantrell gets swatted. Bria Bass, send that home. Marissa Cantrell's trying to force too many shots. Bria Bass lets her know it. Jalen Morrow's back in the game. Warren was on her own. She slowed up to time it right for the layup. And Maria Trimble came out of nowhere and swatted it again. This Tucker team's been playing good defense here in the second half. They're physical. They're tough. First 4 minutes, I think they had four girls dive for loose balls on the floor. They're not going to shy away from contact, and they're not afraid to get whistled for a foul if it's under the guise of making a defensive play. Two blocks in a row, but they call her for a foul on this one. Warren's first and second free throw are good. That makes it a six-point game in favor of the Lions. Sham Sandin with the running floater from the free throw line, a little too far, but she gets the rebound and puts it up and in. So the 5'2" guard gets the rebound under the basket and puts up an uncontested layup. How about it? Warren, pass is tipped, pulled in by Trimble. Trimble's got very active hands. She's a unique player. 5'7", can play post and can play guard. Base drives, no good. Johnson Graham just throws it up. Hansberry in the corner. Back out to Cantrell. No look pass, Warren, pump fake. Johnson Graham with a block. Out to Sham Sandin. It's 2-on-2. What can they do? Hesitation drive. The floater from Sham Sandin is good. I didn't know what she was going for to begin with, but they pulled it off nicely. Sham Sandin with a hesitation running floater. 38-36. Check out this replay. 2-point ball game with a little over 3 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Westlake lost their first game of the year, an overtime loss to Brubaker Tech at the Verizon Hoops for the Keir Classic. Since then, they've rattled off 6 in a row. They beat Carver, a team from Montgomery. They beat Lowndes out of Valdosta. They beat East Coweta. They beat South Cobb. They beat South Atlanta. And last night, a win over the hosting Alexander Panthers. Pardon me, Cougars. They beat them 68-39. They are not interested in losing that winning streak tonight. Paris Mullins tries to make room. Her shot is just a bit short. Maria Trimble with the rebound. Pushes it up to Sham Sandin. Hard foul. She goes down. Cantrell knew it. Sham Sandin up top. Out to Bass. Looking inside for Johnson Graham. Nothing doing. Bass for three, airballed, rebounded though by Trimble. That goes up and in. That's got to be disheartening for a Westlake team. That's the second or third time tonight that Tucker has airballed and then benefited from the airball by way of rebound and put up. Spin move from the freshman. Just missed it. Silly pass there. Right to Jayla Morrow. There she goes on the floor again. What are they going to call? Jump ball. So Jayla Morrow just fresh off of a a stinger on her hand, had to leave the game. Does not hesitate to fall to the floor for a rebound. Deja White coming in to replace Paris Mullins. Bad pass there from Shams Sedin. Hansberry left hand layup, no good. Anastasia Warren and in. Oh, the ball just sat on the rim there for a minute. Jalen Morrow jump step, dishes it to Johnson Graham. They're going to call it for a travel. That's one of those calls that can go either way. You've seen it be a no call. As you just saw, they do call it a travel. It has a lot to do with if you land with both feet or if you land with one foot first and the other. But that call can go both ways. Warren down low to Hasendove. She dishes inside. Tipped away. Cantrell long two. That's short. Johnson Graham with the rebound. Throws it to pretty much no one. Cantrell makes an unnecessary behind the back. Loses it. And it's picked up by Morrow. Drives the lane. Jump stop. That's good. And we're tied. 40-40. These teams are tough. Hansberry inside to White. White out to Cantrell, three ball. Down low, Hasendove, long baseline jumper, no good. And Tucker just keeps throwing the ball away. They catch it and immediately turn and chuck it upfield. Jalen Morrow not going to allow the pass up top. Cantrell, good bounce pass. Circus shot from Hasendove, no good. Deja White with the rebound. She gets fouled. She's going to go to the line. 27 seconds remain in the third quarter. First is good. That gives the Lions the lead back. Morgan Collins comes in to replace Shams Sedin. Her second is good. Westlake's had a good free throw shooting night. They lead 42-40, 21 seconds left in the third quarter. Bass with it on the wing. She drives left side. No good, but Maria Trimble gets the rebound. That's no good. Johnson Graham, she gets fouled and will go to the line. Johnson Graham has good body control. She's got good moves down low. Good hands and can block shots, but it seems like whenever she goes up to shoot the ball, something just kind of goes awry. Talented rebounder, talented defender. Has not had a lot of luck from the floor. First free throw is no good, second one's good. Hasendove pushes it up the floor. Free throw line jumper and one. Gets smacked in the face and stays with it to sink the two-pointer. She'll get an opportunity for an old-fashioned three. Hasendove sinks it, 45-41. Johnson Graham with the ball. Looks for Morrow. Morrow's got to put it up. J. just in time. Does she have enough? No good. A little short on the air ball. All right, folks, it's 45-41. The way this game's going, we're going to be coming down to the wire. We're here at Alexander High School for the Peach State Classic. Don't go anywhere, folks. Fourth quarter's coming up.
Perfect shot feels effortless to me. Right when I release that shot, it just feels serene and quiet. It's only me and the rim and the basketball. With my height, to have an impact and to be the player that I wanted to be, I needed to change my shot, and that was going to be something that would be beneficial for the long term. The process started just breaking my shot down from the initial release to the follow through. And there were days that I couldn't even get the ball to the rim. There were days that I couldn't go outside of the paint area. It was very frustrating to not be able to shoot the way that I wanted to. The hardest part of that process was definitely the patience. But if I just stuck to getting better every day, eventually I would be able to shoot well.
All right, folks, good fourth quarter is about to be underway, and here we go. Oh, clock never started. If you're just joining us, I'm Colin Ritzik. We appreciate you tuning in. I'm here with Lisa Burnett running the show. This is the first of two championship games here tonight. Westlake Lions versus Tucker Tigers. Westlake leads 45-41, and they have the ball. That's Westlake in white, Tucker in red. Rekaya Williams' shot's just a bit off. Bria Bass does all she can to keep it in bounds, but tips it to Westlake. Down to Rekaya Williams. That shot's no good. Huzendove with the tip in. Looks like she was playing 21 on that. Jayla Mora crossover, loses dribble, out to Bass for three. That's going to be short. Rebound, and who they're going to say it's off? They call it off of Tucker, but wait, refs convene. Let's see what they call it here. They're giving it to Tucker. That was pretty much impossible to tell who knocked that out of bounds. Two hands went up for it at the same time. Morrow, jump stop in the lane, no good. Cantrell with the ball. She's on the wing by Hansberry. Huzendove playing the four, and Rekaya Williams down low playing the five. Jump ball. If you can say nothing else about this Tucker Tiger team, it's that they hustle and they play hard. They're tough. They do not mind sacrificing their body to get the ball back. Probably the seventh time they've been on the floor tonight. Morrow dishes out to Bass. She tries the baseline. That's shut down. Kickball. Stays with Tucker. Quinlan Hughes tried to make a move, and she had a lane. Ball went off of Cantrell's foot. Tucker stays with it. Jayla Mora to inbound. Dishes out to Bass. Bass up top, what's she going to do? Picks up the dribble, out to Morrow. Three ball, waved off. We got an off-ball foul on Westlake. Number 23, Quinlan Hughes, called for a push. Trying to set a screen. Gave her more of a shove than a screen. 47-41, six-point game, a little over six and a half left. Westlake, Cantrell, hesitation, drive, baseline, no good. Johnson rebounds, gets it stripped by Cantrell off her leg. Ball stays with Westlake. Kennedy Hansberry in the first half was probably 40% from the field. I don't know if I've seen her shoot a ball yet tonight in the second half. Rakea Williams gets fouled. Rakea Williams, the 6'1" junior. That ball touches about every part of the rim it possibly could have before going in to make it a 7-point game. It was good. Williams has been good from the line tonight. Jayla Morrow to Shamsin Dean, to base, back to Shamsin Dean. Working the perimeter, that's what they did in the first half. That was successful. Stay with it. They found a lot of open holes in the lane early on in the first half by moving the ball around the perimeter. I like what they're doing so far. Not a shot you want, but she got fouled and will go to the line, so a potential for two. Shamsin Dean drew contact and kind of just threw it up. First free throw's no good. Folks, if you've never been to Alexander High School, you should come check it out just to look at it. This place is nice. Looks like a brand new gym. This is my first time coming here. Plenty of seating. They got seats in behind one of the goals. A little walk around track. Nice scoreboard, nice sound system. Beautiful gym here at Alexander High School in Douglasville. Second free throw is good. 7-point game, 49-42. Paris Mullins. That shot's no good. Cantrell rebounds it. Her shot's no good. Johnson Graham rebounds it. Throws a Hail Mary down to Jayla Morrow. She gets the easy layup. 49-44. Kiara Johnson Graham, very good court awareness to get the rebound. No, she'd have Morrow down court for the easy buckets. Coming up next, the boys' championship game, the Whitfield Wolfpack versus the Farrell Panthers. Whitfield's usually a perennial contender in the private A class. Struggled early, they're 5-3. Farrell's 7-1, they're in 3A, region 4B. That's going to be a fun one. Whitfield won last night over North Clayton. Farrell won last night over Morrow. So once this game concludes, we got the 15 minutes for the boys' games. I'm not going to tell you what to do. I'm going to highly suggest you stick around because that one's going to be a lot of fun. But for now, we've got a heck of a 5 minutes left in this Tucker versus Westlake game. Anastasia Warren with the ball to Cantrell. To Hansberry, three ball. Front rim, no good. Johnson Graham to Morrow. Morrow's double teamed on top of the three. Dishes to Shamsin Dean. Corner long two, no good. Bria Bass, good rebound, good finish. Splits Mullins and Cantrell for a tough two. Bria Bass has played a very good game tonight. Hazendove with a little Euro step in for two. There's some athletic girls on this court tonight, folks. You guys are getting a good game. Good dish inside. Finish. Johnson Graham and one. Jayla Morrow eagle eyes. Dishes it inside. J. Johnson Graham finishes. She's had trouble tonight finishing. On that play, she finishes. Puts her team within three. Has a chance now to put them within two. Jerea Dumas, the 6-foot junior, comes in to relieve Paris Mullins of her duties. Let's see if Johnson Graham can make it a 2-point game. Her free throw no good. Whoa. Hey now. Looked like it was definitely tipped out by Shamsa Dean. But they're going to say it's off Westlake. Tucker's not complaining. They get the ball back. Morrow up top. She fakes to Johnson Graham. Gets her shot blocked. Cantrell up ahead to Warren. Can't she catch up with it? Gets her shot blocked. Gracious. It's probably the 6th block shot of the night for Tucker. Jalen Morrow. Pardon me, Shamsin Dean, 5'2", blocking shots. Being an athlete, Warren misses her first. 51-48. 4:19 left to play. Second free throw is good. 4-point game. Shamsin Dean up to Johnson Graham. Back to Shamsin Dean. Back to Johnson Graham. 3-pointer off the front of the rim. Rebounded. Maria Trimble, no good. And Dumas gets the rebound, making her impact felt. Cantrell drives the lane. Up, no good. She goes down hard. She'll head to the line. Cantrell. First free throw is good. SUV TV coming to you live from two states today, all weekend long. Marcus Burnett's been over at the Chick-fil-A Classic in South Carolina with some just probably some of the best action you're going to see all year in boys high school hoops. And myself and Lisa Burnett here coming to you from the Peach State Classic in Douglasville. Jalen Morrow. Draws the contact and we'll head to the line. First free throw is good. Deja White checks in for Cantrell. Up 5, the Lions take out their point guard. She's been in, I think, all game long. Probably needs a bit of a breather. We'll probably see her come back in on the 2:30, 2 o'clock mark. Dumas for 2. Good press break there from the Lions. Found the open Dumas under the floor. Johnson Graham, left-handed hook up and in. So she had trouble finishing early. The last two times she's had the ball, she's finished. Tip of the cap to Johnson Graham. Makes it a 4-point game. Bria Bass comes in hot. Commits the foul on Deja White. A lot of contact in this game. A lot of tough players. Some hard fouls. Good fouls, but hard fouls. Making good defensive plays on the ball. Not afraid to draw contact and make contact. We've seen girls diving on the floor for balls. We've seen a couple girls dive out of bounds. Impressed with the way these two teams have played tonight. You can tell how bad these teams want it. Second free throw, no good. Jalen Morrow, past White, past Hansberry, dishes to base, 3-pointer, good. Tucker, not going away. Bria Bass has hit some big three-pointers tonight. There's Hansberry for three. Misses everything. Anastasia Warren rebounds. Good foul. Westlake, I don't know if they planned on fouling Maria Trimble there. But had they not, that was going to be an easy 2 points for Tucker. They had Bass and Morrow down court. Tucker would have thrown it out. It would have been 2 points. Instead, they foul her under the basket, 1-1, center to the line. That is Westlake's ninth foul. One more, they're going to be in the double bonus. Tucker's got eight fouls, 57-55, 2 minutes, 55 seconds. First free throw's good, 1 point game. What more could you ask for, folks? And Westlake calls a timeout. All right, 57-56, 1 point game, 2 minutes, 55 seconds left. You're in for a treat here. Fourth quarter, end of the game, coming up.
To anywhere on the floor. I went through some tough days, but found a way to just persevere and see it through. It starts with a great base and great foundation and allows everything to feel perfect. I can do all things.
Maria Trimble for the second half of the 1-1. Good. 57 all. Tied ball game. Deja White gets a pass half court. Gets it stolen, but they're going to call a foul on Morrow. Close, but it was a good call. Deja White on the front half of the 1-1. It is Bueno. Deja White on the back half of the 1-1. It is no Bueno. Johnson Graham with the rebound. Gets it off immediately to Bass. She dishes to Shamsin Dean. Morrow, corner, three, good. And the Tucker Tigers take a 60-58 lead on a three from Jayla Morrow. And then Johnson Graham steals it. She's had a heck of a defensive game tonight. Gets fouled in the process. She's going to go to the line. The big lefty playing defense all game long, hustling all game long, is going to get rewarded with a chance to put her team up three, even four. That's the 10th foul on Westlake, so she will be shooting two. First one's good, 61-58. This has been a great game. A lot of lead changes. Both teams have been down 7 or 8 points at one time. Did not count themselves out. Kept playing tough. Johnson Graham's second free throw, no good. 61-58. 2:20 left to play. Anastasia Warren brings it up past half court. Deja White, Rakea Williams. Jumper from the baseline. Good. I don't know if her feet left the floor, so I'm not positive I can call it a jumper. But the shot was good. Bass's shot is no good. And they're going to get Shamsin Dean for the foul there. And that is Tucker's 10th. So now I believe Rakea Williams was fouled on that play. She will go to shoot two. Both teams in the double bonus. Tucker with a one-point lead. First is no good. Needs this to tie the game. In and out, but rebounded by Hasendove. She dishes back to Williams, and that's good. Rekaya Williams misses both free throws, but ends up with 2 points in the possession regardless. 62-61. Bass to Shanson Deeb. Tomorrow, back to Shanson Deeb. Morrow, deep three, just short, rebounded by Cantrell. They're going to get Shanson Deeb for the foul. Cantrell to the line to shoot two, possibly put her team up by three. Second of two is good. Rhea Bass up top, guarded well by Cantrell. Picks up her dribble. Good pass down low. Nothing doing. Jayla Morrow, three ball. That's good. 64-63. Tucker Tigers take the lead. Boy, this one's been fun. Check out the replay here. Good pass by Shamson Deeb to go down low. Dishes out to the wide open Morrow from downtown. She sinks it. 1 point game. A little over a minute remaining. Crowd's been dancing all night long. They're having fun. Players on the floor are having fun. I'm having fun. Good night for hoops. If it comes down to it, who do you want taking a shot to tie or win the game if you're Tucker and if you're Westlake? If I'm Westlake, I want the ball in Kennedy Hansberry's hands. But Westlake breaks the press. Rekaya Williams gets it blocked by Johnson Graham. She goes back up, just misses. Rebounded by Bass. And Tucker with the ball, under a minute to play. They lead by one. And a timeout by Tucker. 1 point, 51 seconds to play. If I'm Westlake and it comes down to the last shot, I want Kennedy Hansberry taking the shot. If I'm Tucker and it comes down to the last shot, it's a toss-up between Jayla Morrow and Bria Bass. If either one of them have an open shot, go for it. But the way this game's been going, I'd put money down that this is going to come down to the final possession. What more could you want? I want to say a big appreciation. Thank you to the folks here at Alexander High School for hosting. They went above and beyond the typical host duties, you know. Usually you have these just regular hot dogs and hamburgers in the concession. No, they had barbecue sandwiches, quesadillas, grilled cheeses. They had crock pots back there. Good old-fashioned home cooking going on. We appreciate the folks here at Alexander being gracious hosts. All right. Maria Trimble. Inbounding. She's got Morrow back court. Morrow trying to shake Cantrell off. She gets double teamed. Shakes to the right. Loses it, but gets it back. Picks up the dribble out to Shamsen Deed. And she gets fouled. Costly mistake there from Marissa Cantrell. It's going to send one of the better free throw shooters in Shamsen Deed to the line. And that is going to do it for Marissa Cantrell, the senior. Fifth foul. Deja White coming in to replace her. Marissa Cantrell goes over and shakes Robin Potter, head coach of Tucker. Go over and shakes her hand. Classy move there from Cantrell. First free throw is good. Makes it a two-point game. Najla Shamsen Deed. Second free throw is good. Three-point game, 66-63. 37 seconds. Deja White with the ball. Dishes it in to Hasendove. The two is just off the mark. Rebounded by Trimble. She pushes the floor. Shamsen Deed. They're going to hold the ball. And now come the fouls. So each possession is of maximum importance from here on out of Westlake. They're going to have to foul and hope for missed free throws, which they get one. They're down three. They don't need a three. They just need points. But from here on out, especially with that free throw being made, making this a two-possession game at minimum, you got to imagine they're going to be doing some purposeful fouls. 67-63, Tucker Tigers lead the Westlake Lions. Westlake's the reigning champions from Region 3. Pardon me, Tucker's the reigning region champions. They're in Region 2, 6A. Lost in the state playoffs to Mountain Creek, 52-30. 7-3 on the year, looking to go 8-3. Westlake 7-1, looking to go 8-1. Deja Warren with the ball. Over to Deja White. Okay, Williams is wide open on the baseline, but they couldn't get it to her. Bria Bass forces the turnover, dives to the floor to get it. And Tucker calls a timeout. Coach Potter called a timeout as soon as Bass hit the floor. Great defensive play from Bria Bass. Gets in the face of Deja White, causes the turnover, gets on the floor, and secures the ball while Potter calls the timeout. Good basketball there from Tucker. They lead by four. There's 15 seconds left. Can Westlake pull something off? They're gonna have to foul. Hope for some missed free throws. Come down and hit a quick shot. Foul. Hope for some missed free throws and hit another shot. Westlake's got an uphill battle in front of it. Tucker will inbound on their side of the court. Pardon me, on Westlake's side of the court. And they get the pass up to Bria Bass. Pump fake. Sends Rekia Williams flying. And one. No basket, they say. don't quite follow that line of thought. Like I said earlier, that's why I'm up here and they're down there. So on the inbounds pass, Maria Trimble finds Bria Bass breaking towards the basket. Looking like Tom Brady, just drops one in perfectly in her hands. Bria Bass pump fakes, sends Rekia Williams flying, gets the foul, heads to the line. They're up four. There's 13 seconds left. Bria Bass, first free throw, nothing but net. Westlake's going to call a timeout. So that's Westlake's final timeout. Thirteen seconds left, Westlake down five. You got to come down, hit a two or a three. Well, it depends really on what happens with the second free throw. Let's say she misses it for the sake of Westlake. Come down, hit a two or a three, immediately foul, hope for the best, come down and hit another two or three, all within 13 seconds. It's looking grim for the Lions. At one point, they looked very much in control of this game. And Tucker never counted themselves out, down 8 or 9 points there towards the middle of the third quarter. It's come roaring back, Bria Bass hits the second. So they need 2 3-pointers. They get the ball in Hansberry's hands. She just throws one up because she had to, and that's going to do it. Elise Rayford fouls. It's going to send Maria Trimble to the line, but regardless of what goes on here, that's going to be the ball game. Trimble's first is short. Trimble's second is long. Loose ball, Anastasia Warren. And time is gonna run out. The Tucker Tigers are your 2015 Peach State Classic Champions. They moved 8-3 on the year. Robin Potter, head coach of the Tucker Tigers. Proud of her team, happy of her team, giving high fives. The two teams shake hands. 69-63 is your final. Up next, Whitfield Academy versus the Tharrell Panthers. The boys' championship. We got one more game to go. Don't go anywhere, folks. We're in for a good one.